What's up, everybody, man? Good morning. It's Saturday, April 18th, and it is 7 a.m. I'm usually up, man, at like 4:30 every day, but for some reason, just didn't want to get up this morning. The way things are looking, I just, the depression is weighing in, and, you know, I try to, like, go to war with my mind. And tell myself, Chuck, there's no time for depression. You know, times are going to get rougher, and you're going to need to be focused and mentally ready for this. And what scares me is I'm on methadone. You know, if people watch my videos, they know that I'm a recovering addict. I've been clean, man, probably almost 7 years. It's been a battle. Every day, all day is a battle in my mind. I'm going to war. It's like I got, you never see that concept with the demon on one shoulder and the angel on the other? Well, that's in my mind all day, every day. I'm going to war. And it's constant, man. It's constant. And I feel like, though, or not feel, I know I've conquered most of my vices. I just got to get rid of this vice, cigarette, which to me is a major vice. Cigarettes destroy your body. Man, once you destroy your body where you can't run, you've destroyed your body. Bad. Because your body needs to take in air and it needs to be able to have blood flow and all that. But, that, and then I just lost a friend in December, my friend JoJo. I talked about that. And then I just lost a friend a week ago today, my friend Bob, man. A real good friend. Good friend. And, it was tough, man. It's still tough. I miss him already. You know, it's only been a week. And I've been through this numerous times in life, so I know sort of what to expect. But this time, you know, JoJo is a close friend, but Bob is even closer, man, because my nose feels tough is because he helped me get clean. He was there for me when I needed someone to talk to. You know, he put up on my attitude. You know, when you're coming off of something that you've been on, you're dependent. And then when you stop, you know, you're just miserable. Any little thing will make you miserable, you know. Somebody could look at you wrong and you're just, it'll piss you off. Just any little thing, man, any little thing aggravates you. So, at the methadone clinic, they're given, it depends on, you know, your urine status and all that stuff. They're given probably the most a week. They gave me 2 weeks, every 2 weeks. And that ain't looking good. You got to go through the DEA and all that just to dish out the medicine. So for them to do this, they don't even want to give a take-home for a snow day, really. They didn't want to do that back in the days. Now, they're kind of a little more lenient with that, but what it took to get to this point. Now, I'm a firm believer that methadone helps people, right? So, I'm just thinking as I talk, sorry. You know, I know I do that a lot. I went back and watched myself, too, just to interrupt this part real quick. And, you know, I apologize to everybody. It's not that I have an attitude and I think I'm smarter than everyone. I think I'm better than anyone. That's not it. Like I said, man, honestly, I feel like we all have been bamboozled, and I know we all are smart, and we all can do more, and we can get away from this, because we did this. We, you know, we're smarter than what the moves we're making now, and I know this for a fact, and it angers me when people, you know, try to tell me I'm crazy, and I might be crazy, whatever, man. You got to be crazy to live in this world. So, you know, research, man, go look this stuff up. Like when I say a virus has to be injected, so what's really going on? You know, and no one, you know, I go and tell people this, and they just look at me like, but the news said, and that, you know, that's starting to really, and it's not like they're saying it because, how could I put it? They're not saying it because they truly believe it. Or yeah, that's why they're saying it. But it's more or less because they don't reach it. That's all they know, the TV. And I'm not putting no one down. Oh, my ear, man. There's like something in my ear that hurts. Anyway. So, I don't think I'm smarter than no one, even though I could be. But the point is I want people to question everything. I want people to see how grimy the government is, you know, and we vote for these people. We keep them in office. See, it used to be to the point where the people were the power, but I'm starting to think that's not the case because they bought up everything, the land, the ocean, the food, the air, the airplanes. They own it all, man. The military, the police, the TV stations. I mean, they own it all. And you know why they own it all? Because we sold it to them. Because we were struggling and we needed the money. And so we sold it for a cheap price. You know, I'm starting to learn all this stuff. How do you own a house for a year, right? Never miss the payment. You miss one payment and it'll take your house. At least here. You know, that's crazy. No wonder no one could ever own a house. Imagine paying a house 30 years. And then at that 30-year mark, you start struggling. You miss one payment and they take your house. I just, you know, who wants to be a part of something like that? You know, they talk about God and the government and this and that, but they have no God in their heart at all. The God they have in their hearts, that's another thing. We use the word God loosely, too. Like, I could say God, and then some people think I'm talking about their God, the bad guy, Satan, right? Or you could say, you know, there's so many so-called gods that we worship. But in general, nobody knows if there's one God or many gods that works with one God. You know, I mean, we could question it all day. We could question how old the Bible really is. I was watching this video on Flat Earth Water, I think that's the name of his channel. I'm not positive. He's over in Europe. Good channel. I think he's a Christian guy. Which there's nothing wrong with that. Just because someone's a Christian, they believe in Jesus. Jesus, and you know, was the son of man, God's son, in the book, right? So I always question, you know, because I like to put myself in God's shoes, and not that I'm God, I just want to try to feel like he does sometimes, like, you know, like, just not feel like him, but try to understand the moves he made, put it that way. So I think to myself, would I send my son down for an example? I don't think I would. But I guess we're too different, you know. And I was, you know, they teach you not to question anything. And that makes me want to question it more. Is that like reverse psychology they do on you or something? Just trying to smoke my cigarette and talk. I don't like smoking directly on camera with cigarettes because it just, the kids, you know, if they do happen to watch this, I don't want them to think smoking's cool because it's not, man, not at all. Smoking is not cool. Trust and believe that. I used to think smoking was cool when I was a kid, and then I got older, you know, and drugs and cigarettes ruined my teeth too, not just car accidents and stuff like that, man. It had to do with drugs and cigarettes. Cigarettes, the dentist said mainly cigarettes. If you got a cavity and you smoke cigarettes, the chemicals in the cigarettes will destroy your teeth. But it got to the point with my teeth that I just had to start taking them out. And I just never finished because that's some painful stuff, man. If you ever had a broken tooth down at a gum and they had to cut your gum on each side, and then they put, like, you know, like the thing you open the wine bottle with? Well, they got a smaller version. and they put that in, squeeze, they put it into your tooth and they just whoop, and it's pretty painful. Dentist says, oh, you won't be in no pain tomorrow morning. You look at his teeth, he never had one pulled. So I do want to apologize if I have an attitude sometimes. No, I appreciate everyone who subscribers. I appreciate everyone who even watches the video and don't leave a comment. I appreciate people who leave a comment. I even appreciate the trolls and their bum selves that like to go around and mess with people. That don't bother me, man. You can come on here and say whatever you want. I got thick skin. I grew up in the early 90s. You know what I mean? I grew up in the era where you stare at somebody wrong, they'll break your face. You know what I mean? I grew up in an era of a lot of respect. You know, this era, these new kids, they don't got respect. They don't know what respect is. You know what I mean? They don't know how to fight and lose a fight to come back tomorrow. They want to kill you right away. See? You know? And they think that's cool. They think killing people is cool and not having respect is cool. See? And I don't have respect for that. I can't find respect for someone that don't have respect for someone. Just because your girl cheats on you with some guy, you're going to go shoot the guy and spend the rest of your life in jail? That's cool. Like, come on, man. That girl cheated on you, she don't love you, man. She don't care about you. Move on. Why kill the guy or the girl? That don't make sense. The guy owes you $5. I know it's the point, but it ain't worth killing the man and going to jail for the rest of your life. Maybe beat him up, you know? Give him a good beating, you know? But don't kill the man. It ain't worth it. There is a point, though. It don't, you know, your word is your bond, man. Your word is you. And 99% of the time, I like to keep my word, you know? And when I say something, I try to do what I say because that's everything, man. You know, I might have been a drug addict, I might have stolen money from my family, you know, and I feel like a piece of crap for that, man. It haunts me every day because, see, in my life, people would say, oh, well, why don't you, you know, try to talk to your family about it? I can't because they all passed away. I can't fix my problems that I created. It's my fault. So I got to live with it the rest of my life. You know, people say, oh, I'm sure, you know, your grandfather forgives you and your aunt. Yeah, no, I don't really truly believe that because I can't talk to them and get a definite, you know. People say, oh, they're in heaven looking down. Well, I don't feel definite either, man. Because when I hit the tree and I died, I seen my life flash before me, but there was no promising anything else. I believe I died and came back because my friend James, he was driving in front of me. I was driving behind him. I blacked out. He said he looked in the rearview mirror, he seen the car go off the road, whoo, bow, and rolled the car over. He parked up the street, ran to the car, said, thought I was dead. He started shaking me by my shoulder. I was like, you know, blood was everywhere. He said I looked dead, and he got me to come to. And I remember my life flashed before me, man. I seen from when I was a kid all the way to that point in life. And I swear to you, on the Holy Bible, it was insane how fast my life flashed. I seen important parts of my life all the way to that moment. And it was almost like a sign. I always try to decipher that. What was God trying to tell me, man? And what God was trying to tell me was, look what you have. Look how beautiful life is. And you want to destroy it with alcohol, drinking and driving and doing drugs. And I didn't get that message then because I was just so in tune to me. You know, I was in a selfish way. So that's what God was trying to tell me. You're destroying your life, Chuck. What are you doing? I'm going to give you a second chance. And then I heard my friend James, Chuck, from far away. And he shook me back, I guess, into life. And now I think God is giving me a second chance. sometimes in the back in the days I'll complain, be like, why did God let me live, man? All this stuff I'm going through. And once again, I'm thinking selfish. When I start thinking selfish, I automatically start thinking, I got a roof over my head, thank God, man. I've been homeless, you know, I had no one to turn to. My family has been gone for a very long time. 18 years since my mom's been gone. And then my mom basically kicked me out. It started when I was like 14. 13 is when I started to get bad because, you know, I used to get picked on and stuff because I was a quiet kid. And it came to a point in my life where I got tired of that shit. You know, I didn't want to hurt people. Hurting people ain't cool. People think hurting people is cool until you overhurt somebody. Then it ain't cool no more. I used to get picked on a lot and slayed and stuff. And then thank God I went to that residential. Because that residential, it taught me how to be a man. It taught me how to fight. It taught me how to stand for myself. You know, my friends tried to show me that. But it wasn't like this place. I had a counselor take me under his wing, Mr. James. I always wondered what happened to that guy. He taught me how to box. I thank Mr. James for that. They used to let us box in this residential. If you had a problem with someone, you could tell the counselor and they'll set up a little. They'll give us gloves and they'll set up a, you box each other in the living room. You know, that probably wasn't legal rules, but they'd rather us do that than try to kill each other at a young age. I went into a residential at the age of 14, New Haven, Connecticut. It was called St. Francis Home for Children. And I was in the parole building for kids. I was on parole at the age of 14. Because I went into Hartford Detention. And then that place was hell. Hell on earth for children. It was like, you know, the prisons in the 80s and 90s. Well, it was the same way, but for kids. It was hell. Hell. Fucking 3-4 kids in the cell. It was hell, man. I never forget. They put me in the cell in Hartford detention. And then I was in the cell with two other black kids. And I had the what? The boat on the floor. Of course, the white. They put the white man on the floor. Get on the floor, white boy. No, they were cool as hell. One was a Muslim. I forgot his name. I was thinking about this last night. And then they let me go home on the bracelet. So now I played for the Elks Club, baseball. And I found this picture. And this picture. And this picture. And here's my other picture. I don't know what the other picture is, but I found that picture. You know, I talk about me and my mom going to powwows and my mom's boyfriend. Well, that's me. And my mom's boyfriend, Pete, rest in peace. We used to go to powwows. I don't know how clear that is. And that was me in the residential. This is 19, I was 16. This was 97. This is 2 years. I was about to go home around this time. That was my, almost 2 years in. I was about to go home. And this was me as a baby. My mom used to let me hear music, so that's probably why I love music, and I'm good with poetry and words. But I learned a lot from being in the residential, man. I learned how to be a man and at a young age, and I learned keep Miss L, man. That was a very good woman. See, I used to drop the N-bomb a lot when I was a kid, and I'd be like, what up, nigga? You say, what up, nigga? And I'm with the ER, the A, always, you know? Because that's how me and my friends talked. You know, I hung around a lot of, I don't like that word, black people, man. Nobody's black. I don't like to say backgrounds, neither. were Polish, German, like I always say, man. But anyway, I had a lot of black friends. And, you know, it would be dope if we could, like, stop calling each other white and black and start calling each other by what we really are. Don't let them take that away from us. I know I'm 20 minutes in, but I'm just talking, man, and I hope people watch this. And you know, I apologize if I sound like the a-hole sometimes, and I sound selfish. That's not the case, like I always say, man, and I apologize. You know, I'm going to try to work on that, and it's not sound so. I went back, and the video that I erased, I went back and watched it, and I'm like, oh, man. People, no wonder no one watches me. And I apologize to that, everyone. And I will work on that. I just want people... it's like, not that I want attention. It's like, I want to do more so bad that it angers me that my channel's lingering so slow. And plus, the stuff I speak about, they don't want my channel to blow up. YouTube does not want my channel to go nowhere. The so-called computers see what type of soul I am, and they're like, we need to take that guy down. I'm not going to talk too much longer. It's been 20 minutes. I just wanted to apologize for my past videos, and you know, I'm not an asshole, man. I'm a good guy. I just want to get to know people, and I want to do more. I want to help more people. I want to change. I want to be like, you know, Martin Luther King. I always looked up to him, man, because he took a spot that not many people wanted to do. And you know, people say, you know, yeah, he was a revolutionary for the black people, but in my eyes, he was a revolutionary for everybody to look up to. Everybody, look at the stuff he said, or if you want to call him his teachings or his messages. He wanted freedom, most of all for his people, but most of all for everybody. He knew what was up, and they shut him down. And in the circle that was around him, I think was infiltrated by two people, or maybe more, you know. He was infiltrated and ratted on and found out where he was going to be, and they killed him, man. God bless Martin Luther King. That man was gonna do big things, and he still did big things. It's this world is something else. I never thought I would live to see this, what's going on, but I am. I'm here. Tomorrow I'll be 39, man. Tomorrow 39. So I'm not gonna talk no more much longer. But thanks to everyone who listens, man. I appreciate it. And like I said, I'm working on a video for the Masonic symbols in New Britain, which. It's stuff, this work's not easy, man. I gotta walk everywhere, you know, until I buy my car in a couple months. I gotta walk everywhere and take pictures, you know, it's not, you know, and then I gotta edit everything, and it takes time. Even the other videos, when I look for pictures and how I want to express myself, it's not like I just pick any picture. I look through hundreds, thousands of pictures and pick the best ones. So... And, you know, that's just how that works. And just please, everyone, try to get me to enough subs so where I can go live and I can do more, man. You know, share my video. Leave comments. Even if they're comments that, you know, I'm open-minded. I'm not going to, if someone got something different to say, I'm not going to block them and say, fuck you, you know, stuff like that. I'm open-minded, man. Leave what you think. And... we'll talk about it. Stay safe. Stay free. That's number one. That's most important. Even though we're under God's constitution, you know, even though God's laws are more free than man's laws. You know, God has his rules or her rules, but be safe, everybody. You know? So next time, if there is a next time, peace, man.